What a do. Matt Bale FPV here, coming at you from the home workbench, feeling more obliged than ever. And why do I feel more obliged than ever, you might ask? The answer is you guys. As you may have noticed, I, over the weekend, reached 100 subs, something I actually never expected to happen, never thought would happen. When I started this YouTube channel about 7 or 8 months ago, I thought I would have maybe 4 subscribers. Like, 2 of them being my brothers or something, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't think anyone would care. But you guys have proven me wrong in the best way possible, and I thank you guys for it immensely. I mean, I don't even know what to say. I know a lot of you have already left wonderful comments of congratulations and felicitations on my last video, which, by the way, my last video was uploaded before I hit the 100. Otherwise, I had really meant to address that in the last video, but it was already uploaded and done and everything, so I just kind of decided to let that ride. But that did not go unnoticed, and nor did the surpassing of the 100 subscribers, which I know is honestly a big milestone, like the kind of the first big milestone for a YouTuber. So that's pretty cool, and thank you guys so much. I don't know what to say, honestly. It's so cool. But anyway, something I do have to share for you that's probably more interesting to you than my appreciative rants, not a rant, more of a soliloquy, but if you will. But it's another rainy day. Well, I guess it's not raining anymore, but it's just gross. It's been gross outside for like a week, and it shows no signs of letting up. But I figured I'd show you guys. I have like a really good, what I consider to be a pretty good backpack for FPV. It's really cheap, and I figured I'd show you guys kind of my gear, and maybe there's some gear in here that would help you, and maybe there's some gear in here that I, or some gear I don't have in here that I could use that you guys could recommend. Anyway, so let's get into that. I guess to start off, here is my backpack. Unfortunately, as you guys know, because I lost my other chameleon last week, I would usually have it right here. And this is a LAPG, Los Angeles Police Gear, I believe, backpack. It was given to me by a buddy of mine for free when he upgraded. It was his hiking backpack. And it's pretty thin. Right now I've got it really tightened down and everything, but it can hold a bunch. It can hold a lot more than what I've got in here. I guess I'll start with the outside. Here we got Bluetooth speaker, of course. I can't leave home without that. Quad, always important. The way I have these quads, the way I strap quads when I have more than one on here is just right through the middle of the X on just a regular, got some like Velcro straps from Home Depot, cut the ends off, made them as long as I needed them. And these little tactical what have yous are all over the, it's on the sides and everything. So you could honestly, you could strap more than 2 quads to this thing. You could strap probably 4 comfortably and maybe 8 very uncomfortably. Anyway, that seems to be all of the outside. You got, you know, these two, buckle straps right here, so you can kind of cinch everything down. It can make for a very slim setup. I guess next I will cut to kind of down on the backpack level and start unpacking it. See what you think.
All right,
and here we are down here with the backpack. Is this a good angle? I don't know if this is a good angle, but we'll roll with it. First of all, undo these little straps here, and then we'll start with the top, kind of where I keep all my tools. I used to just keep them loose in here, but then I got this kind of triple threat bag tool thing. In my first one, just got normal drivers and things, all the hexes and pliers and cutters and what have you. Following that, I've got this bag pretty much of just adhesives, super glue, electrical tape, a lighter for heat shrink, a pair of small scissors, and in here I have these, never leave home without these, hemostats. Don't know if you can see that, but these are basically, I forget what you call them in science class, grabbers? I think that's the scientific name for them. Some grabbers. as well as some solder, extra battery checker, power cord for my portable soldering iron. So that's my kind of my tools. I've got a couple extras just kind of rolling around in here too, a little baby hammer and some extra pair of pliers. And then in the second, we got a second pocket down here. Undo the old bottom buckles. Second pocket is a whole bunch of stuff. So second pocket, I got antennas, a mad sack of antennas. Can never have enough antennas. I realized that something I've realized with the Chameleon, I don't know, I don't think it's a design flaw or anything, it's just kind of the way she goes, is that by having the antenna connector coming straight out the back and like connected right here, instead of having the antenna kind of more inside the body, you tend to break a lot of these off. I don't know how to avoid it. Am I doing something wrong? I doubt it, but could be. But I lose an antennas, I don't know, probably as much as I lose props and battery straps, honestly. Second thing is Bag-O-Misc, miscellaneous items, smoke stopper, extra receiver, extra GoPro lenses, rubber battery pads, some prop nuts, a bunch of heat shrinks, broken flight controller, zip ties, just your knick-knack bag of stuff. Next up, battery straps. Now I go through battery straps like, I don't know, like people go through water. But, you know, Boobs FPV, stylized with two O's, you guys might be familiar with him. He's a great pilot, but he recommended these. These are RJX Hobby Kevlar battery straps. So this, the stitching, the yellow stitching is Kevlar, so they say. And I've been running one on this, unfortunately, because my stack is a little too, I can't run two of them because it's too thick. But this thing, man, it has seen some real crashes, like no kidding crashes, and it, there's almost no damage. And I've run it through probably a good 20 packs, 20 to 25 packs, and I would have normally lost a battery strap, you know, several times over by then. So as you can see, I have quite the supply. But those are the straps. And here I got some more zip ties. M3 screw set. This is a bag of hardware, just miscellaneous hardware, prop nuts, screws, things like that. ESC protectors, just some spare ones. I've never run these. I've always wanted to, but they seem like too big for an ESC, I don't know. But anyway, here we got spare ESCs. My pride and joy. This is the TS100 portable soldering iron, powered by XT-60s. And this is a must-have if you're gonna do any kind of soldering in the field. This is probably, it's probably the best $75 that you're gonna spend as far as field purchases are concerned. I'll leave a link to this. I'll leave a link to really everything in the description, and you guys can pick and choose what you wanna click on at your own discretion. Here I have some spare. I'm actually running really low on MMCX pigtails. I got one, it looks like maybe two left. It's just some spare VTX stuff, a spare run cam micro in case anything goes wrong. My tried and true, trusty Weaver throw bag. My throw line would also normally be in here, but it's actually kind of broken right now, so I have it sitting up here until I can get a new one or fix it. Spare battery for, I think this is for my Tyrannus. I don't use it a lot because I don't have, I guess, that many packs. I'm not usually out at the field like all day. I'm usually going out for kind of a session. But in the, I think I've used it once and it came in really, really handy that one time. So I keep it in here. Spare lighter for heat shrink. More zip ties. Fishing weights. More fishing weights. Bunch of rubber grommets just kind of hanging out loose in there. And that does it for kind of the extra stuff. Another thing I wanted to mention when I was picking up this bag, I got some of those foam landing pads in here. I got some more over here, but you know the foam landing pads, I basically am just asking in general. You see how this, like the electrical tape goes, there's a little piece of a prop in here, kind of that Mr. Steel style ESC protection. And it's like piece of prop, ESC, arm, and foam pad. And I just kind of wrapped the whole deal in electrical tape. And I, since starting to do that, I have never once had to replace a foam landing pad, unless I had to actually, you know, replace a whole arm. So can somebody tell me if this is a bad idea? And if so, why? I mean, is it weight? Are people trying to save weight? Because, I mean, how do you land without losing those things? I don't know. But if you don't do this, and there's no detriment, then I would definitely recommend doing that. Just wanted to mention. Anyway, back to the backpack. We got this huge midsection here, which I don't even come close to filling up. And I got my batteries, all 8 of the packs I own, right in here, along with a battery checker. And here, got my goggles, using like an Omway, omnidirectional, got the triple feed patch, really good patch, running the Dominator HD3s, classic, oldie but a goldie, and I got 2 18650 kind of extra battery packs for the goggles. When I started out, I had this charger that wouldn't charge the Fat Shark goggles, and I also vape, so I don't know, it just seemed like a better idea to go with the 18650 battery packs instead of the normal ones. Anyway, so I did that. Right up in here, in this section, that's where I keep props. These 6 props are the last props I have right now. Well, actually, they're not. They're the last 4.3 HQs that I have right now. In the mail today, I just got, they actually came really highly recommended from Shaka X and Magic Smoke FPV. Those guys have really been talking highly of these. They're the HQ 4.5s. So I got me a little, a couple bags of those. So I'm gonna try those out soon. Watch out for that coming your way, probably. See how they work. I know I tried the 4.8s and they just like destroyed my batteries. They were entirely too much pitch. Anyway, so that's where I keep my props. You could probably hold a good five or six bags of props in there. And then finally, at the bottom, providing the foundation for it all, my Tyrannus. Now I use, got her here with the old Skull Rotor Riot protectors. And you might notice that this guy is red. If you don't know, that is the, you might remember a while back when they came out with the M9 gimbals with those really good chips. I upgraded to those and they were great. It was actually an immediately noticeable difference, which I wasn't expecting it to be starting out. It was kind of like 2 or 3 months of me getting into the hobby, and they were so great, and I was thumbing at the time, which I don't recommend, by the way, and I was converting to pinching right at that time, and I found with the pinch, right? So on this one is fine. Like I didn't really seem to have any problem getting onto the pinch and all that, but over here I kept feeling like I didn't have enough throw when I would hit the throttle. Like, it's hard to explain. Like, I would just punch, and it didn't seem to have the same punch that I had when I was using my thumbs. So I switched it out for this M9R gimbal, and I think it's more intended for racing. It gives you a 60 degree, or this one's 60 degrees, and this one's like 45 degrees of tilt or something. So it's basically a shorter distance from end to end. And what that did was it shortened up my throttle band so I could better throw the stick, because it had a shorter distance to travel. I'm sure that makes sense, but yeah, would recommend if you are converting from thumbing to pinching and find that you're not getting enough kind of throw with that throttle, try the M9R. Not bad. Easy upgrade, too. So that's what I do. In here, I got a lens cap for my quad. And I would... My next thing is I'd really like to get that TBS Crossfire. Yeah. One of these days. One of these days when I have money again. But anyway. So that is basically my... let me cut back up to... So yeah, that's her. That's basically my backpack. LAPG. About $45. Leave a link in the description. Thank you guys again from the bottom of my heart so much for the 100 subs. That's an absolute wonderful feeling to know that you can put out some kind of artistic endeavor and to have people respond to it really positively and to have fun while you're doing it. It's awesome. Speaking of which, about to cut out to a parking lot or something on this rainy day and see what we can rip. Catch you guys later. Thanks for the watch. Peace.
And I'm back from Digitaria with an empty humor and a human pretzel duke. Tapeworm harvest, egad and gadzooks. Soul catcher, canis major, trade embargo, tachyon nostril, trachea console. Your bizarre cosmological study buddy. I'm the only Noah, only 23, there's no cop. Growing poppies, Illuminati, G-Lodge, Bebop Rock, String Theory, Springsteen, Elohim, Equinox, when above, Enuma Elish, California dreaming, Uber Alice. Your army salivates from Salvia Valis. Palace of smashed glass, hall of mirrors, three-dimensional syntax, jazzy veneer. It's the atmospheric pressure cooker. What the fuck to walk here if the shores come in? Grab a twin and pile in. Smashed, will I be able to remember and then bring back? Sting that contraption, honeycomb wrap scaffolding, function paternalia, rudiment grid phonic, the largest skid harness and bling jib lozenges that will rid you of your sharp cartilage. It's the frigid air, crystal clear, idea Pangea, banded hair streak, blitzkrieg, guerrilla theater. 23 liters of tequila that's built to spill, an anonymity veil that illest student suits me well. MacDonnell, dwelling, interstellar, cellular automata, cracking the oracle, for better or worse. I beckon the insects to come forth while these MCs are bathing in a salty frost. Batwing, lost oblivion, speed pill, weevil warp marble, this the PL. Square oranges, squeegee kid, BT bottle, nervous is not in the vocab tomorrow. Phylum, vines on the walls of the city, forever just prove that green is infinity. Here's some basil mash mixed with cactus juice, but after that you just might have to puke. Seven rats follow your nose through the gateway of marvels, not exalting cleverness, unimpeded harmony resolves, complication continuous, just on the brink of existence. Spirits keeping centered, for those who don't know, those who know don't say, this is photo soul decay.